Mother.
Yes.
I'll be going now.
Okay, bye. Take care.
So you'll take care of Louisa?
Don't worry. I learned my lesson. I'll be careful from now on.
All right. Goodbye.
Bye.
Goodbye. I love you.
We have something to talk about. Let's go back inside.
What's it about?
You're telling things you shouldn't.
What?
I said, get inside already. You and your big mouth. You're trying to make me look bad to my son.
But I really didn't say anything.
Oh, really? Then why did he confront me? Why did he give me a warning?
Please believe me, madam. I really didn't tell him anything. I only said to him that I'm very afraid of you.
You're right to be scared of me. I haven't even begun showing you what I can do. I can do absolutely anything for my son. So don't try me in a fight. You don't want to see me really angry.
Madam, please tell me, what did I ever do wrong to get this kind of treatment?
You started interfering in our lives. That is your crime against me. And every crime has a punishment. That's your sentence, Louisa. We'll see if you last.
Nene, mm-hmm. Why are you just walking?
Oh, I had the driver drop me off because I went to the bookstore.
Uncle Tito, this is Nene. She's a new friend of mine. Nene, this is Uncle Tito.
How do you do?
I'm well, thank you. I was just driving Mark to school. Why don't you come ride with us?
There's no need. And the school's not far from here. I'll be okay to just walk.
Uncle, I think I'll walk with her. I'll see you.
Okay. You two take care now.
Thanks for the ride. How come you need a driver to take you to school? Don't you live somewhere nearby the school?
What? But how would you happen to know where our house is?
Well, some of your friends told me that you live in the house of the Medell family.
That's right. I do live there.
Maybe I could visit you there sometime. We're related anyway.
What? You're related to Madam Manang?
Well, not to her. Uncle Tito is the cousin of Joaquin Medell. Did you ever meet him, the husband of Madam Manang?
I didn't. Are you close to their family?
No, I'm not. I don't even think they know about me. Say, maybe I can visit you there someday so that you can introduce me to all of them.
Okay.
I'm sorry, Totoy. I don't have time to chat with you. So if you don't mind, please leave now. Just come back next time. I already told you. I don't have time to sit around and chit-chat with you.
I really didn't come here to see you. But your brother, Diego, please tell him I'm here. I need to talk to him.
Oh, now I get it. That's why you're very close to Diego. Now I really understand.
What's that?
You're a coward.
Pardon?
Coward. Then you learn how to be brave from my brother, Diego. He can teach that. Maybe you can be
no,
a man.
I'm no coward.
Maybe
I'm no
you
coward.
Can be a
I'm
man.
I'm not afraid. What now, huh? What do you think, huh? Am I a man? Jojo. 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 Open the door. Jojo.
Mind your manners. Stay out of my life.
Jojo. Jojo.
Get out of here, coward.
Jojo. Jojo. Jojo, please come down. Jojo!
I told you to go! You're so rude! Go back home!
I got carried away. It's also your fault. You pushed me to do it.
I don't care what you say. I will tell Diego.
I'm sorry, okay? It's your fault for mocking me. Jojo!
Leave me alone!
I said I was sorry. Joe! Jojo, please come back. Please give me another chance. Jojo!
Hey, Totoy. What's wrong with you?
Why don't you ask your sister?
You know she told me you're a coward.
Diego, are you kidding? I'm not a measly coward. This guy is all man.
Okay. I know that anyway.
It's your sister's fault.
No, it's your fault. Why don't you court my sister? It's obvious you have feelings for her. So what's stopping you?
Well, I don't want to hurt Mother. Just like Luisa did.
Then don't make the same mistake she did. Don't hide anything from your mother. I also wouldn't want you to elope with her or marry too young. So what do you say? Will you court her? Go on, do it.
Think I have a chance with her?
So what do you think?
Hey, why are you still here? I told you to go away.
I want to apologize to you. I really didn't mean to let that happen.
And you're very persistent, aren't you?
Oh, hey! I really don't understand her. One minute she's nice and the next she's all cranky. Sometimes she's like a girl and then she becomes all aggressive. She's definitely tough.
Totoy? Who are you talking to?
No one.
What is that on your face?
Nothing, Mother.
Son, tell me the truth. Are you and Jojo a couple?
What? No.
What are you saying? You quarrel like the two of you are already together.
It was just she was making fun of me earlier. There's nothing between us. Why, Mother? Don't you like Jojo?
It's not like that. You cannot get into a relationship before the right time. That's exactly what happened to your sister. Finish your studies first.
Yes, Mother.
Hi there, Diego. Would you like some water? And me, do you like me? Fine. Hey. Why do you look so troubled? Did you fight with someone? Tell me all about it. What's on your mind, Diego? I will listen. I will be a great confidant. Talk to me.
Saling, what's new with Luisa?
Oh, come on. I thought you were going to confess something about how you felt, but you just changed the topic. Anyway, I think Luisa's okay.
And how is her mother-in-law?
She was mean before, but when she allowed Luisa to get married to Carding, I think she became nice to her.
Really?
Of course. That's just how she should be to Luisa. Because if she picks a fight with my best friend, so help me. Myself, my mother, and Edad, we will all get really mad. And if the three of us join forces, we will most certainly win over Madam Menang. And why do you have so many questions?
Oh, you should stop frowning there. Madam might see us and she will scold you again. I once heard something from Tekla. Madam Menang is easy to get along with. Just follow everything she tells you to do. Don't ever question a single word that she has to say. If you say yes to everything, she will ignore you and you will not get into trouble.
Okay, Belen. I was wondering if I could ask a favor. If possible, please don't tell anyone about what happens to me here. I don't want it known to my family.
I know when it's time for me to shut my mouth. Don't worry, okay? They won't hear these stories about you.
Thank you.
Why don't you eat some dessert to cheer you up? It's very sweet.
Edad! Edad!
Oh, no. Edad! Are you okay? Edad! Wake up! Wake up, Edad! Wake up, Edad!
Luisa, we brought your mother to the hospital.
What? Which hospital? Okay, I'll go there right away. Madam Menang, may I just go somewhere for a short while?
What, now you want to leave us?
Oh no, madam, I just have to go to-
Luisa, I was clear with my instructions to you. I don't want you going out. I don't want you leaving the house.
Madam, it's just that it's an emergency.
You're not leaving this house.
But madam, I have
You're not leaving this house, period.
Your wife is very sick, sir.
What do we need to do?
She's had a fever for a while now, and it looks like it's been ignored, so her condition worsened. Her platelet count is too low now, and at this point, it's crucial that we conduct a blood transfusion.
Same blood type as my wife, but the nurse said we could still donate some.
Yes, sir. It's just to replace the blood that your wife will be using up from the blood bank. Have you filled out the needed form?
Yes. Here you go.
Let me look at it. I'm sorry, Thomas. It looks like you can't donate blood. You have high blood pressure. As for Totoy, he has asthma, so he can't either. Nene, I see you're taking medicine for your colds. For how long now?
I've been taking it for 2 days.
Then you can't donate either. Especially not you, because you're too young. I'm sorry, sir, but none of you is eligible to donate blood.
Would you go and call Luisa? I don't like to sit and wait around.
Madam, I already looked in her room, but I didn't see her there.
Then look again.
I will take care of all the hospital expenses, Thomas. You don't have to worry about those. May I help you with other things?
Perhaps you know people in other hospitals because they said they don't have any more type B blood in the bank here. They're looking, but it's not looking too promising.
Sure, I will look. I will go to town and ask around for someone who can help Edad.
My blood is type B. I can donate blood for mother.
Madam, Luisa is really nowhere inside the house.
Just as I expected. She's doing this to test my patience.
Oh, hello, Mother.
Your wife ran away from home.
What?
Luisa wouldn't do that.
Well, that's what she did. She left suddenly and went without a single word.
I already asked Tekla to search everywhere in the whole town,
but no one has any idea as to where she is.
Maybe you picked on her again.
What? Karding, I made a promise to you.
You just refuse to believe me when I tell you the truth, that you have an inconsiderate wife.
She won't cooperate with us. That is what makes me mad.
Totoy, I heard about your mother.
How is she? Mother needs blood. She's in critical condition.
Totoy, do you really have to avoid me here as well?
Sure you can stick around for long? You may not want to get your beautiful clothes dirty.
Totoy, come on.
Get out of here. You shouldn't be here anymore.
Totoy.
You're rich now. You're now with those who live life at the top. Forget the poor family you had before.
There's no truth in that.
Which part is not true? Did you ever think about how none of your family is happy? We are practically living on salt just to save some money. And Piping only gets one bread for the whole day at school. We don't even have money to buy books. We don't always get to eat. Why do you think Mother got sick? Whole day she's breaking her back to make money for our family. While you just sit around, napping away every afternoon, just lying on money every day.
Totoy, Totoy, if only you knew.
If I knew how hard it is to live in a big mansion, or just how difficult it is to sleep in a big room that is fully air-conditioned, or if I only knew how bitter it tastes to eat good food every day. Give me a break, Luisa. Let's stop joking around.
Kuminsan ang takbo ng buhay mo, ang pagdurusa ay walang pag maninimdim ang buhay ay gulong ng palad, gulong ng palad. At may kapal marunong tumingin.
Thank you, sir.
Sa tamang hirap at nasawi.
Father?
What is it, son?
You can have this small amount of money I made to buy medicine for Mother.
Please excuse this. I never used to be a crybaby.
No, it's okay to cry. I know it's hard to be away. Being apart from your family. And no one's on your side in your new house. Especially against Madame Menem. I passed by your house this morning. I saw how she was hurting you, Luisa.
Diego, what you're saying is not true. That's a mistake.
Luisa, you don't have to deny it. And don't worry, I won't tell this to anyone.
Diego, there is nothing to tell anyway. There is no one hurting me in any way in that house.
I understand, Luisa. If you're not ready to talk yet, that's okay. But there's one thing you should know. If you need any help at all, I'm right here. Anytime.
Bye.
Luisa was gone the whole day. Mother doesn't know where she went.
She'll go back home.
You know, I feel something's happening in that house I don't know about. I don't know who to believe anymore.
You know what I think? Even if I don't know Luisa well yet.
What?
I know you get annoyed by your mother, but I'm thinking that she's just doing that out of her love for you. Maybe you should believe your mother.
Your wife's platelet count has improved, but it's still too soon to say that she's now out of danger. We need to keep her under observation.
Thank you, Doctor.
You're welcome.
Thank you. There's nothing else you can do here. Go home and rest.
Father, I'll stay here with you.
Okay. Nanette, Bibbing, get going now. You have class tomorrow.
You don't have to worry. I can take them home.
Thank you very much.
Luisa, if you want to come along, I can take you home too.
Thank you.
Bye, Father.
See you, Luisa. You take care now, and thank you again.
Don't mention it, sir.
I'll see you.
Well, here we are. Thank you.
Okay. Oh, Luisa, wait.
What is it?
You just keep in mind everything I said to you. If you need any help, of any sort, don't hesitate to come and ask me.
I'll remember.
Where have you been? Do you know what time it is?
My mother is very, very sick.
And now you answer back?
I was just explaining.
Are you disobeying me now?
If it's already my family that's concerned, then I dare to defy you. It's just like what you said. You are willing to do anything for your son. I'm the same way with my family. I will gladly take on any fight for them, even if that means it's you I'll be facing.
You have no respect. You are so rude.
One thing my parents taught me was to respect other people. To respect parents in particular. So if I really had no respect for you, I'd have disobeyed you long before now. I'd have stood up for myself and not put up with all of this. Respect is the only thing that stops me. Respect for you and my love for Carding.
We're not done yet.
Let you put go. Let go of me.
Let's see you put up a fight.
Take your hands off me.
Let's see you put up a fight.
Mother? Luisa, what happened here?
Carding, you have to help me. Get her away from me. You should have seen what she did to me.
Carding, you should let me explain first.
Let's talk later,
Luisa. Don't believe what she says. Did you see what she did to me? Your wife is horrible. You don't know her.
Oh.
thank you.
Are you okay now? Mother, what happened?
You have no idea how worried I was when I couldn't find Luisa. So when she came back, I was distraught. I scolded her and said she should have never run away again, that she really scared me with what she did. Then she suddenly started screaming at me. She got all hysterical. She said that it was none of my business, that it's her life and she'll do whatever she wants. And she wasn't contented with the fact that she was shouting at me, son. She even slapped me and was pushing me around. I don't know. It could have been my fault too, because I reprimanded her. But I was so worried about her, that's why. That's why I did that. Garding, I've come to care a lot for Luisa. Tell me, did I do anything wrong? Was I out of place? Tell me if I was.
Garding, how is your mother?
She's finally asleep. I had to help calm her down. Luisa, why did you do that?
Garding, I didn't do anything wrong.
Don't lie. I saw you push Mother down to the floor. You have no right to hurt her, even if you're my wife. You know it's improper. Not even my father had that right.
Garding, it's not what you're thinking. I was the one hurt by your mother.
Even still. Sure, Mother can be hurtful with her words, but those are all just words. It's not a valid reason for you to mistreat her.
Garding, that's not exactly what happened.
I saw what happened. And what you did hurt me a lot, too.
Your mother's awake. Huh? Dad, you're going to be all right.
Mother, are you okay? How do you feel?
I feel a little weak. What happened anyway?
You fainted and the doctor said you were in critical condition. Good thing you had a blood transfusion last night.
Who donated the blood?
We got it from the blood bank here.
I'm sorry, Thomas. I'm causing problems again. A burden, as always.
That is not what's important, Adad. Don't think about it. Just focus on getting well again. We'll take care of everything.
Mother, are you hungry? Do you want me to feed you?
Where's Pepin?
Oh, he's in school now.
And
but
Nene.
They will come visit later.
Garding, your food's ready.
Luisa, I have something to ask of you. I hope last night scene won't happen again.
Aren't you going to hear my side of the story?
Okay, I'll listen to it.
Garding, you should leave now. Maybe you can still catch your afternoon classes.
Never mind then.
Okay. Bye. Mother, I have a favor to ask. Please don't scold Luisa too much so we can avoid this kind of trouble, okay?
I'm still the one at fault. I was the one who got hurt, and I'm the bad one.
Mother, no, I just want you to get along with Luisa. Make this thing work. Maybe she's just not used to you, so she got fed up and she pushed you.
Karting, you know I'm doing everything just to get along with her. Then again, you can't really know the true personality of someone unless you live with them every single day. Now that you know the real person behind Luisa, what are you going to do?
Mother, we're still adjusting. We're discovering new things about each other. We need to accept these things and learn how to deal with them because we're married now.
Garding, all problems have solutions. And you know that I've always supported all of your decisions. Even if I disagreed, I still did what I could for you. Like when you wanted to marry Luisa, I helped you then. Now, if you want to end things, just tell me and I'll help you.
What exactly are you saying?
What I'm saying is, if ever you want to separate from her, I won't blame you for it. I'll let you do what you want. I'll even help you.
Good morning, Madam Menon. Can I please talk to Luisa?
You can't. Tecla, come close the gate.
Oh.
You are no match against me, so don't get too comfortable in this house. Do you understand me? You should know one thing. You will never be better than me. I'll make sure you don't stay here for long. So don't you try me. I can do much worse things than you. Keep that in your head.
Luisa.
Celine, what are you doing here?
Wait, why are you crying? What happened to you?
Celine, you better go. You better leave right now. If Madame Menang sees you, you and I both will surely get in trouble.
Hold on, Luisa. Just wait a second. Will you tell me the truth? Are they treating you poorly in this house?
No.
I don't find you convincing. You better not be keeping secrets from me. I want you to tell me what they're doing to you.
Celine, just get out of here. If you stay any longer and Madame Menang sees you, she will scold me again for sure.
So you're saying she is mistreating you?
No, Celine, just leave now to avoid a scene, please.
You know, I'm getting confused with all your answers. And why do you call her Madame Menang? She's your mother-in-law. You really should tell me the truth, Luisa, because right now it's not looking good. Luisa?
Celine, I'm having a very hard time here. It's so difficult to live here. I don't think I can take any more.
Father, is it true that Mother's already well?
Almost, Beping. She can leave here tomorrow.
Yippee!
Father, here's the hospital bill. It's 10,000. Where are we going to get that kind of money?
That's okay, Nanny. I even thought the overall cost would be higher than this. A loan from my office again.
No need for that, Thomas. I will take care of paying the hospital bill in full.
Really, madam?
Of course, Thomas. It's not like Idad's a stranger. I treat her like she's part of the family. That goes for you all.
That's wonderful. Thank you so much, Madame Carmen.
You're really kind, Madame Carmen.
Thank you, madam. You just wait and see when your father finds out about this. Oh,
please, do not tell my father and my mother a single word about this. They can't know. I don't want to add any more to their problems, especially with mother in the hospital.
Your mother is already well. I think she comes home tomorrow, Luisa.
Even still, they can't know about this, okay? Because if they find out what's going on in this house and Madame Minim finds out, she will do everything in her power, like use all her connections to guarantee that my family's suffering too.
But that's not right. No one's here taking care of you. Are you just going to let them keep doing this to you? Say, maybe you can talk to Kerding. He's your husband. Tell him.
He wouldn't believe me if I said his mother was capable of doing bad things.
Is that so? Just as I guessed. That's what I've always thought he was. He's been spoiled by his mother ever since. Excuse me for my honesty. I'm just getting frustrated about all this. Why don't you just leave your husband?
Celine, I love Kerding. I cannot do that.
Then what's going to happen to you now? Plus, you don't even want me to ask help from people outside. Are you willing to let them continue mistreating you?
Celine, Madame Menang is testing me so that I will surrender. She wants me to leave this place, but I won't. I love my husband and I will fight for him, no matter what happens.
But that's not right. Fine, okay, if you say so. But if you ask me, a good kick is all she needs.
Celine, please promise it to me. Promise to me that no one else will know about this. No one. Please.
Hi. I didn't see you there. How is your mother feeling?
She's much better now. She might be coming back home tomorrow. Jojo? There's something I've been meaning to tell you.
What's that?
Jojo, I just want you to know that...
Jojo, a drink for you.
Hey, thank you. That's really sweet of you.
Of course.
Doi, this is Jaboy, a classmate of mine. Jaboy, this is my neighbor, Dodoy.
Hi there.
Maybe we can talk again next time. We have to go to the bookstore.
You ready?
Let's go. There might be a long line there. So, where are we going later?
It's up to
you. What are we doing?
You want to see a movie?
That sounds good.
And that was his conclusion. The truth is the whole, according to Hegel. Well, that wraps up our discussion in European philosophy. Thank you so much for joining us, Mr. Medel.
Sorry, madam, I had to attend to a family emergency.
It's okay. But I hope you did an advanced reading, because there's an exam later based on the lecture you missed.
Alex, can I borrow your notes in calculus? I need to catch up.
Here.
Thank you.
What's going on with you, Kerding? How will you graduate this year if you don't attend classes every day?
I'm dealing with too many problems. It's so hard to concentrate, adjusting to university life and also to married life. I still have too many questions.
About calculus or about life after marriage?
Both. Even when it comes to my wife. Alex, I really love Luisa. But there are things about her that I'm just now finding out. and they are unbelievable.
That's the thing. You got married too early. Come on, you're supposed to think long and hard about it before starting out married life.
I already know that, Alex. There's no need for you to rub it in. There's a lot I don't understand now. I don't know what to prioritize either. I'm failing in my classes. Mother and Luisa can't get along. And even Luisa and I are starting to fight. My head cannot take it anymore.
You regret doing it?
No, I don't. I do not regret marrying Luisa.
Diego, I feel bad for Luisa. She gets hurt in that mansion. And she doesn't want me to tell anyone or to get outside help for her. Hey, why aren't you reacting to what I'm saying?
There was a time when I saw Madame Annam hurting Luisa. I just wasn't sure if I saw it right. Now I can say it's all true.
Oh, no! Diego, then that would mean it has been going on for a long time now, and we just never knew about it. Oh, what's happened to my best friend? But wait, Diego. Don't you say anything about it to anyone, especially to her parents, because she doesn't want them to know. I said I wouldn't tell. I promised Luisa.
You know what? I just don't understand. Why won't you just come home?
No, to her, that's not an option.
I'm sure whatever problem her family has could not be worse than her putting up with mistreatment from Madame Menem. What's that I just heard?
Oh, no.
Madame Menem is hurting Luisa? Saling, answer my question. Is Menem mistreating Luisa?
No, Thomas. It's not true, no.
Then what was that you two were talking about?
Well, the thing is, we sort of heard a rumor about something like that, but we have absolutely no proof that it's true.
Is Menem responsible for the wound on Luisa's lip?
I don't know about that. Promise. Promise.
Wait a second. Where are you going? Please come back.
Wait, Thomas! Please come back!
What are you just standing there for? It's time to eat.
I was just waiting to hear from Cardin, to know that he was able to get back to the city safely. Did he happen to call you?
You shouldn't keep the food waiting.
Wait! You can't just come in here like this!
I want to talk to my daughter!
No,
Where is she?
Hold on! Madam!
Thomas!
Father, what are you doing here?
There's something I want to know. And this cannot wait any longer. Madam Menem, have you been mistreating my daughter?
What? And where did you hear that crazy lie?
Luisa, you tell me the truth. How did you get that bruise that's on your lip? Don't be scared. Tell your father the truth. I will protect you. Are people hurting you in this house?